Hi everyone, we are talking about anti-patterns, and the specific one that we are talking about is using databases as message queues. So if you're using a database to send messages from one server to another, that's considered an anti-pattern, so you should avoid that. And let's take a specific scenario. Let's say you have servers S1, S2, and S3. They are connected to their clients, mobile clients, desktop clients, and they talk to each other using this database. So whenever S2 has to send a message to any other server, it goes to the database and then puts an entry. So that's an insert command. Similarly, S1 and similarly, S3. So in our case, S3 has a cron job or something. So it just entered in the database that it needs to talk to another server. So through these inserts, you are telling the database that there needs to be some communication with some other server. So how will the database actually tell it to the other server? The database cannot talk to servers. It can only receive. So the other servers have to poll this database at a specific interval, let's say 5 seconds, 10 seconds, and ask it, is there any new message for me? So if you take S1, it's probably going to have a polling interval of 10 seconds. Every 10 seconds, it's asked the database that, is there a new message for me? If so, then I'll just read it. And after reading it, it will do something with that message. So in the first case, if S3 is sending a message to S2, and after 5 seconds, S2 tries to read that message from the database, gets it, and pulls it out of the database for itself. Let's say the ID was 123, so it gets message ID 123, does something, and it might change its internal state or send something to the client. This is a standard queue. There's nothing great about it, just the database is being used as a queue. But why is this an anti-pattern? One thing is the polling interval that we just talked about. That's a problem. When you're polling a database, you're actually doing a lot of read operations on it. And if you're polling it very frequently, you're putting a lot of load on the database, continuously asking it, do I have any new messages for me? So that is, if you have frequent polling means there's a lot of load on the database. The other side of the coin is long intervals. If you poll at long intervals, well then maybe S2 needed the message quickly. And because it has a long interval of 50 seconds, the mobile should have got the message in the first 2 or 3 seconds, that's the expectation. But instead it took it a full 50 seconds. So S3 wanted to send a message, it took 50 seconds, the user experience is bad. So long intervals are inefficient. Here's the problem with just polling intervals. We talked about why read operations are going to put a lot of load on the database. It brings us to our second point, that a database is usually optimized for either reading or for writing, not both. So when you have both operations being performed on the same database, it's going to have issues. Issues like locking, issues like deadlocks, so on and so forth. But just understand that if you have something like a CRUD model, which is CRUD, this stands for create, this stands for read, this stands for update, and this stands for delete. In this CRUD model, what we do is we study how much time do each of these operations take. And databases, these are write operations, and this is a read operation. They're rarely designed such that the read and write will both be fast. In fact, I don't think it's possible to design a read and write database optimal data structure. This brings an interesting point. What if your servers are talking to each other very frequently? What if there are a lot of messages that S1, S2, and S3 are sending to each other? So this database is going to get filled up with those entries. Now, you need a lot of space either to store all that data or you can start clearing that data. So if you're not going to delete that data, then you'll need to update it and mark it as completed. So that's an expensive operation. And the other one is to manually delete these entries, either manually or use a cron job. In both cases, the deletion is going to be using scripts, using complicated logic, and that's why that's the third problem. The final issue, which is a very big issue for large systems, is scalability. So if I have a new server, S4, and I start asking the database for messages sent by other servers, and then S5, and S6 and so on and so forth, this database is going to be unable to handle that load. It cannot perform so many read operations. So one thing I could do is actually add a new database, which is going to be talking to S5 and S4. In this case, the obvious question is that how does S4 talk to S2? And there's no clear answer. You could get your way around this. Of course, you can make a complicated system in which there's going to be a broker in between, and whenever S4 needs to talk to S2, there'll be a database in between or something. But there's no need of that much complication when you have a system design concept, a data structure which is going to do this, and that is message queues. So the anti-pattern here is that we are using databases and message queues. Instead, we should use specialized message queues when we have a very large system. Okay, there's a star over there when we have a very large system. Message queues are going to avoid all of these problems. You know, the polling interval is not going to come into consideration because message queues push the message to the other server. So instead of the server asking, the message queue is going to give the message. So it's not going to be inefficient in that way. The second thing is they're optimized in the sense that there's not too many read operations. So writing to it is easy, while reading is really the message queue's responsibility. So it's going to do it in its own free time. And the other thing about scalability is also going to be taken care of, because if you need more message queues, you can just add them. You can throw more money at the problem and get more of the same thing. So like everything that is nice, message queues also have their drawbacks. The major drawbacks are when your system is not very large, because if you do not have those many servers, then the database will be able to handle the loads that you throw at it. The second thing is, depending on your system, maybe there's not a lot of messages being sent between the systems. In that case, writing is going to be expensive, but it's going to be few, while reading is going to be a lot, but you can optimize your database for read operations and it still works. The third thing, which is a people or a social problem, is that whenever you introduce a new concept to a system, it requires training, it requires time. And maybe this system is not worth the effort. It's a call that you have to make, but maybe databases are perfect as message queues for you. And so have a look at the drawbacks and have a look at the pros, and then decide whether you want a message queue or a database. But if you're asked this question, let's say in an interview, then don't start off with a database without asking what kind of scale is this system supposed to handle. Because 90% of the time in system design interviews, they're going to be asking you to scale the system or handle a lot of users. If you're using a database, that's an anti-pattern. So keep that in mind. It's not always bad, but for large systems, it is. This topic has been discussed extensively in technical circles and blog posts. So if you have any ideas or if you have your own comments, you can leave them below. The description contains relevant links to those discussions. So have a look at them, and I'll see you next time.